A few weeks ago I reviewed the Bluesound Node Icon streamer and I was quite impressed with the sound quality. It appeared to use a newly developed filtering for the digital to analog conversion called Qrono. Qrono d2a and Qrono DSD are claimed to be new technologies that make d2a conversions sound significantly better and are spin-offs of MQA. When MQA went bankrupt 2 years ago, Lenbrook, the parent company of NAD, Bluesound and PSB speakers, bought the assets. In addition to MQA, this included the SCL6 codec, which has been rebranded as Area. A new product called Focus is now also on the menu at MQA Labs. Area is designed for high-resolution audio streaming and Qrono for enhanced playback quality, while Focus is designed specifically for recording and mastering stages of audio production. I have always seen the importance of the time blurring reduction part of MQA. It was clever. Analyze the time behavior of a particular DAC chip and compensate the music stream for it before it goes into the DAC. It resulted in better sound quality for affordable DACs. But there was a poor market acceptation, so MQA as a company didn't make it. In retrospect, I think the marketing was poor. Firstly, the total package of techniques, special coding, bit reduction techniques and time blur compensation was too complex to sell to the mass market. Second, the PR language was rather inflated. MQA's PR people and the computer-oriented audiophiles failed to understand that the claimed lossless quality was about the sound quality and not about having the same bits in the audio file. Thirdly, manufacturers must have their products certified by MQA. This costs the manufacturer money and will delay product introduction. At the same time, that was really necessary to maintain compatibility. Nevertheless, there is quite some MQA-certified equipment in the market and new MQA-certified equipment is still brought to market. Of course, by the Lenbrook brands. But for instance, also the Fio S15 I reviewed recently is MQA-certified. Qrono d2a is a patented digital signal processing technology developed by MQA Labs. The technology uses minimum phase filters that are claimed to have no ringing in order to keep the leading edge of musical notes as unaffected as possible. According to MQA Labs, the filters are tuned to preserve the shape and timing of the transients. Think piano notes, strings and percussion. The filters are said to be designed with the human hearing in mind. Specifically, how we perceive timing, spatial clues and tonal balance. The algorithm tunes the PCM output to how we actually perceive sound in space. Qrono DSD converts DSD files to PCM using the same filter technology. What to think of this? As far as I can see, Qrono d2a is the MQA reconstruction filter on its own, probably further developed. I know these filters from equipment with MQA decoding built in, like the Mytek Brooklyn Bridge 2 in my recent setup 1B, and I love it. It might not be the best filtering in the world, but it's better than many other products in that class. The same goes for the Bluesound Node Icon. It was the sound quality of the Icon that made me look into Qrono. The workload of producing a video each week made that researching this took a bit longer. I am, by the way, considering to take more time for research and skip a week when necessary. I also plan to take more short holidays, which might have the same effect. I'll keep you posted. Back to Qrono, for it has already been ridiculed on the web. As a reaction to a line in the Qrono white paper, a blogger stated, "But seriously guys, digital sound capabilities have exceeded analog, especially vinyl, for decades already. you know right away how serious to take that comment. I reported on the influence of time smearing indirectly and directly ever since I heard an early core DAC. If I look back at the DACs I had since then, they all had a better than average time behavior when compared with DACs from the same period. And I have been ridiculed by the boys with scopes from time to time. In the meantime, publications on the time resolution have appeared, making clear that our auditory system has a time resolution of 7 microseconds. Indeed, microseconds. This means that FFT measures, which are often used for audio, don't have sufficient time resolution, as can be read in Human Hearing Beats Fourier Uncertainty Principle by Lisa Ziga. See the link in the description. I'm really curious on what equipment with Qrono we will see in the future. And on that bombshell, we come to the end of this video. There will be new videos soon, so subscribe to this channel or follow me on Patreon, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram or TikTok to stay up to date on new videos. Patreon and YouTube Premium subscribers see my video a week earlier and ad-free. Help me reach even more people by giving this video a thumbs up or linking to this video on the social media. It would be greatly appreciated. A big thank you to the viewers that support this channel financially. It keeps me independent and allows me to improve the channel further. If that makes you feel like supporting my work, the links are in the description below this video on YouTube. I'm Hans Beekhuizen, thank you for watching and see you in the next video. And whatever you do, enjoy the music.